I don't suppose you've had time to read Richard Desmond's book.
I have not had. Ever since Richard gave us money to the UKIP, I have not read his book.
Very interesting. Yeah. Yeah, but he's. You do crop up from time to time.
I cropped up from time. What did he say about me?
Well, he said mainly complimentary things.
Mainly,
about,
I mean, what were the things he didn't say?
Well, he suggested that maybe you have quite a hold. I mean, agencies in general and WPP in particular, especially on the UK media owner scene, in terms of, you know, who gets what, and he
that may have been a benefit to him rather than disadvantage, I think.
How do you think he did as the owner of Channel 5?
Well, he did. He, if you look at it financially, I think it turned an investment of 100 million into 400 million or whatever it was in a relatively short period of time. But, you know, to be honest with you, I was surprised he did sell it. The new owner, Viacom, we have a big relationship with, obviously in the US and indeed in places like India. Mm-hmm. And, over a long period of time. So, in a way, I'm a little bit disappointed that Richard was a short-term owner or medium-term owner rather than a long-term owner. I thought he was going to build the brand, the Channel 5 brand, for a longer period of time. But, you know, the home it's found with Viacom is something that gives us the opportunity to work with clients on the content side and beyond, and building an even stronger brand.
Did you find him easy to deal with, Richard?
No, Richard is not the easiest man in the world to deal with. somewhat unpredictable, I guess, is one way. But, you know, at heart, he's got a sort of heart of gold, but a tough exterior.